So BMW over the last couple of years has done some pretty controversial redesigns of all of their popular cars, starting off with the M3 and M4 and 4 Series, and then the 7 Series got the treatment with its big massive nostrils and little slits for headlights. And for 2024, BMW decided to give us this, the all new 5 Series. And not only do we have a normal 5 Series, but next to me is going to be the i5 eDrive 40i, which is their entry-level i5 model. And today, I'm going to be bringing a review of BMW's most controversial, newest 5 Series. I'm Aiden, and you're watching God Next. Now, starting on the exterior, where most of the controversial opinions come from, let's go over what BMW has done, because they've done a lot. To start, let's talk about how they've now oversized the grille on this car like they have on every other model out there. As you can see, these have gotten bigger like they do with every generation. But the good news is it's still relatively small compared to something like the 3 Series, the 4 Series, I should say M3 instead, and the 7 Series. Relative to those cars, these aren't bad. Of course, because this is an i vehicle and not a normal one, you have the i badge right here. And BMW actually has made something smaller, and that's going to be these new LED headlights right here. Overall, I think on the front end, it's not too bad when you stare at it for about 5 minutes and kind of get it ingrained into your brain. But the second you go and look at an older 5 Series, you realize that that one does look better. Now on the side, some other changes here. Got these 20-inch rims. These are upgraded from the standard 19s. New mirrors, basically the same going all the way to the back. You have a 5 on the C-pillar now, but we can head to the back and check out what they've done back there, because there's some pretty cool things. All right, now on the back of the 5 Series, there's some interesting things going on back here. Complete redesign, basically, new tail lights. Because this one is electric, it's an i vehicle, you have the blue around the BMW logo. Let's talk about charging real quick though, because over here is where you have your charging port. Of course, it being 2024, there is support for DC fast charging. Now the thing is, even with level 2 charging installed in your home, it's still gonna take roughly 10 hours to charge this thing from 0 to 100%. Now that's not bad if you leave it overnight to charge, but if you do take it to an AC charger to, you know, do a little bit of charging on the road, maybe you're getting coffee or something like that, it's not gonna charge very much. This has a total range capacity of around 270 to 295 miles. And when we took it out for the first time with 92% battery, it had around 216. So those numbers might be a little skewed based on the environment you're in and the conditions outside. Now, trunk space back here, of course, is pretty decent, but this isn't the worst part of the cargo. Now, I wish there was a little more room when it came to the load floor. I wish it was a little lower. But that's not the biggest problem. The biggest problem is up front, where you would expect an electric car to have more space, it doesn't. In fact, they've put this weird engine cover over basically an entirely empty area, an empty area that they could have converted into a small cargo area. That way you could fit more storage, because that is one of the many benefits of owning an electric car, is having the frunk space up in the front. But BMW has refused to give that to you. Now here, I'll show you what I mean when it comes to this engine cover right here, because it is pretty depressing. This looks like something important would be under here. And there are some things, but if I go ahead and pop this out, which takes little to no force at all, as long as you know where you're pulling, and you lift this thing up and undo all the little clips, and you lift this up, you can see that there's probably 5 to 10 cubic feet of just empty space that BMW has just left out under the hood here that they could have used for additional cargo space. I don't know why they didn't. It seems kind of like a lazy thing, especially from a brand that's commanding almost $80,000 for this specific car with these specific options. I would have appreciated if they would have at least put some cargo space in here. They could have reconfigured some of these tubes and hoses, and they didn't. Listen, if Tesla can do it, BMW can do it. That's my philosophy behind it. So now the inside of the new i5, this is where BMW has really changed the game for the 5 Series. Because yes, when the 3 and the 4 Series came out, they were different, but I didn't really feel like BMW changed much. I mean, of course, the interior design overall was different, but they didn't really evolve the interior. But now sitting in the new 5 Series, it's a completely different world compared to the last generation. This one is running the latest version of iDrive 8. I think it's iDrive 8.1. 2 massive screens. You have self-driving capabilities on this car. AR modes on this car where you can literally pull up an image of what is in front of you, a live video feed, and project different navigational things onto the screen. But Mercedes has been doing that for quite a bit of time now. I believe 2018 Mercedes was doing that, which was 6 years ago. But anyways, I digress. You have ambient lighting scattered across the interior, everywhere on the doors, under the iDrive screens, across the passenger side, and even around the climate controls. Speaking of climate controls, they've also changed a lot of the vent systems in this car too. You'll notice that there aren't any vents sticking out. And the interesting thing is enough is they're all integrated into this little part around the ambient lighting bars. And the way you control those vents is through these little sliders on the dashboard right here, which you can manipulate using your finger. They're touch activated. And to change the direction of the air coming out, you actually use these little rubber dials that are kind of embedded under the dashboard, where you can direct the air and the current depending on which way you want it to go or how high or how low you want it to go. Pretty cool. Another thing that I think could break in the future on this car if you decide to buy a used one, you know, 5, 6, 7 years down the road, but nonetheless, cool design. Wireless charging, 2 cup holders, good size, piano black plastic going across the entire center control stack. BMW's gone away from having shifters and everything except for their M cars. Even if you've seen renders of the new M5 coming out, it still has its big shifter. But now you have this little razor thing, like a face razor right here in crystal, which is an option on this car where you can select the mode you want to be in, reverse, neutral, drive, things like that. You also have a crystal control knob for iDrive 8. I'm glad BMW has not removed that. Crystal volume knob as well, and some other things like here, drive modes. Now, things I want to talk about with the drive modes. This is super cool. And BMW is actually, for the drive modes, developed different sounds that were developed by Hans Zimmer. And based on when you're driving and everything, and I'll get into it more on the driving review, different sounds will play, especially if you're in something like expressive or sport mode. You have these different noises that play based on your acceleration, and it just is such an incredible experience. I love gas cars more than I like electric cars, but what BMW's done to make this feel a lot more cool, I guess I should say, is they've implemented features like this using really popular and talented artists. Now, as for the comfort of the interior, materials and things like that, I want to say BMW could have done better. Yes, I understand this is a base 5 Series, but this also cost $80,000. The wood grain on the dashboard feels good for the most part, but this is the new Vigenza synthetic leather that they're using on the seats. It's soft for the most part, but you feel around in some places, and it definitely feels cheaper than what you would usually expect from a BMW. On top of that, I don't know if this only extends to the iTrim, but you also have this cloth weird stuff on the door panel, and in some places, things just feel kind of cheap in certain places on this car. And when you're spending $80,000, I would have expected BMW to maybe put a little more effort into making the car feel a little nicer. But I digress. As for storage space, you have a decently sized center console with still a 12-volt socket. Surprise, BMW hasn't got rid of that. And then, of course, your glove box, which I think could be a little bigger, but you might be able to fit some things in there, like a registration paper. Other than that stuff, I think the front seats have really been changed to really just give you this whole new experience. It's like a baby 7 Series cabin, which is always kind of what the 5 Series has been, but it definitely gives off these 7 Series vibes, though I'd really like to review that car because that thing is absolutely insane. Let's move to the back, see how the back passengers are going to be when they get into this car and see how comfortable and happy they're going to be. Now, in the back seats of the 5 Series, I am pleasantly surprised, actually. I didn't think I'd be that impressed, but it's pretty nice back here. You have USB-C ports on the back of each of the front seats with these little connectors right here, which is a BMW accessory connector that can hold iPads and stuff like that, and then you can charge them using the USB-C accessory. And on top of that, you have 2 more USB-C ports down at the bottom with a little bit of a storage tray here. Legroom is good. Headroom is all right. This one has the Sky Lounge, which I guess I don't know how it works, and I looked for it for like half an hour. I know in the 7 Series, it is really cool, these LEDs and everything, but I'm pretty sure on the 5 Series, all it does is stop as much UV from coming in as possible. It doesn't look like there's any LEDs or anything
in the sunroof of this car. But yeah, it's supposed to have the Sky Lounge, but I don't see much things Sky about it. I think there's do have LEDs that come out of the side right here. Other than that, like I said, it's pretty comfortable back here. BMW's gone away from those crappy cup holders that kind of pop out for these normal stationary cup holders here, which I commend them because they've been doing that forever and those things suck. You have these sun shades right here, and you actually have an electronic one behind me that if you put the car in relax mode, it'll actually lift that sunshade back there and close the sunroof. And another sunshade, of course, right behind my head right here that you can unhook. Definitely trying to make it feel like an executive luxury saloon where you can put executives in the back of and they can be driven around in comfort. Now, one thing I do want to talk about, and I wanted to wait till I got back here to point this out because of how big it is. But back here, you can see this massive Bowers & Wilkins sound system grill back here in this kind of bronze color. And those are throughout the car about everywhere. This is probably one of the best sound systems I've heard in a BMW. The Bowers & Wilkins sound system you can get in the 7 Series, which is even crazier than this one is. And I think it lacks a bit of bass, but soundstage and treble, as far as that goes, this is incredible. Way better than if you were to get the Harman Kardon system like I have in my M4, which also lacks bass, but still really good soundstage. I'm just saying, if you're going to get an i5 or a 5 Series, make sure you get the Bowers & Wilkins sound system. It is so worth it, 100% of the way. All right, driving the i5. Let's give it a little bit of an acceleration test here in normal mode. Oh, not super quick. The M60 trim level of this is definitely a lot faster, but what you heard there, those background noises, because there's no exhaust noise that comes out of an electric car, obviously, BMW has found a solution to make it a little more engaging. And that is they've created these noises and sounds by famous artist Hans Zimmer. And they basically put it in as acceleration sounds. I'm going to put it into its sportiest mode. And you're going to hear what I'm talking about here because it does sound pretty incredible. So if I'm a little bit on it, you can kind of hear it. But then if you go in and kind of stomp it to the ground, that noise, I know it's not the sound of a V8 or an inline six, but it's so intoxicating to hear that. It's like the THX intro to a movie. It's so funny to hear those noises. It makes me smile every time. I wonder how many focus groups BMW went through to get this sound to be able to do that to people, to put a smile on their face. Anyways, we're gonna try a different mode here. We'll put it into expressive. So ridiculous. What is that noise? Oh, I love the violin sounds when you're just kind of cruising. And then you put your foot back into it. That's got to be the coolest thing when driving this car is hearing those noises. It's so cool. Now, the way it drives, honestly, it just handles like a normal 5 Series. There's nothing special to this car at all when it comes to the actual way it handles. It's electric. You get that instant torque. You get 335 horsepower, 295 pound-feet of torque. So very similar to what the B58 did in the last 5 Series. And you can still get the B58 in the 5 Series. Well, not yet because they only have the, I believe it's the xDrive 30i, which is just the inline 4. Still makes decent power. But it just drives like a normal 5 Series, to be honest with you. It feels like I'm just driving a big Uber car or something like that. Nothing too crazy. But that's basically it when it comes to the handling characteristics of this car. It's not really anything special. Visibility's good. It is comfortable to drive. It soaks up the bumps in the road decently well. I mean, it is a little stiff, I feel, at certain speeds and everything like that. But for the most part, I just need to hear this one more time. God, it's so intoxicating to do that. But for the most part, it drives just like you would expect a normal 5 Series to. They didn't give it that kind of boring feeling, and it doesn't feel super boring to drive, which I do enjoy a lot. But overall, I would say I know people are hating on it because it's electric, but until you really drive it, once you do drive it, you're just going to realize it feels like a normal 5 Series just without the sound of an engine. And if you're going to get a normal, like, let's say, xDrive 30i 5 Series anyways, why not just get the electric version? Because that inline 4 isn't doing anything for you. It's not making any noise. It's going to be more expensive to fuel up. So why not just get the i5 eDrive 40 instead of just the regular xDrive 40i, but you get an entirely different modified experience with it. That's my feeling on it. If you like M5 or like something like the M550, you should just wait until they put a V8 in the new 5 Series and go from there.
So even though it is a very controversial car, I think BMW has done something pretty magical with at least the interior of this car. I think it's a lot better put together than the old i vehicles, and I'm talking like i8, i3, and things like that. I think now that they're really focusing full force on the i-line brands, I honestly think the 5 Series will do just fine. I wish they didn't manipulate the outside too much like they did, because I really like the last generation, the F90, after the LCI. But I think most people get used to this just like they got used to the G82 and the G80 and then the new 7 Series. Of course, people got used to that stuff. They'll get used to this. But I think BMW, for the most part with this car, has done a fairly good job at making it more modern and on par with competing with the newer Mercedes and Audis out there. And yeah, for the most part, all good with me. If you guys liked the video, make sure you hit that like button down below. If you want to see more from us, make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.